Friends, my name is Sujoy. Our current presentation is about personal protective equipment. What exactly is personal protective equipment and what is its relevance in the Indian subcontinent? Personal protective equipment is a medical protective dress meant to protect doctors and nurses from the contagious virus like corona. It is required to be worn whenever doctors or nurses are in near vicinity of affected patients of corona positive human beings. It consists of a complete overall from head to toe, including covering for head, shoes, and facial masks. It also includes facial masks, visors, or face plus eye covering equipment. This is a one-time use and throw equipment. What does the PPE constitute of in the pictorial? As you can see, it is the complete suit, the goggle set, pair of latex hand and gloves, a 3-ply face mask, pair of visors or goggles, shoe cover, and a hood which is used to cover the head. Why is the PPE required now? PPE is the only equipment which can protect our doctors or nurses from the harm's way. In absence of PPE, there is large chance that doctors or nurses can be affected by highly contagious coronavirus. In such case, the doctors, nurses start getting the virus. It leads to sealing of the entire hospitals and increases pressure on the already strained Indian health system. We have already seen such cases happening in large cities like Mumbai and Delhi, where entire hospitals have been sealed because the doctors and the nurses got this virus because of exposure to the patients, because they were not utilizing proper protective units. Without our corona warriors, how will we safeguard and ensure proper treatment of corona affected persons? Let's take a demand and supply of the PPE equipment as far as India is concerned. Due to our current corona pandemic, there is a heavy requirement of such protective gear in all hospitals where corona patients are being treated. Governmental agencies and personnel like healthcare workers, police workers, civil volunteers who are visiting red zones, which are areas having high potential of COVID patients. These PPE suits are usually one-time wear and throw due to the highly contagious nature of coronavirus. Once used, these suits need to be disposed of and burnt in high temperature furnaces so that any trace of the virus is eliminated. The Indian story as far as the PPE demand and supply, the war against corona is primarily led by government hospitals. The private sector participation is relatively low at the moment. It is expected to grow up as we go ahead. The Indian procurement mechanism is highly bogged in red tape and extremely slow. While the current situation because of coronavirus is being attempted to be improved. Each hospital requires ideally 2 to 3 suits per person deployed for a 24-hour shift. Typically, this suit can be utilized for 7 to 8 hours, after which it has to be thrown away. If a hospital, say, has a regular strength of 40 personnel for corona or COVID department, of say 6 doctors and 34 nurses, it would require approximately 150 PPEs for every 24-hour shift, expecting that we divide the entire shift into shifts of 8 working hours. So approximately 120 into 30 working days or 3600 per month PPE suits are required in a single hospital for the month. The Indian requirement of PPE suits for every seriously affected corona patient hospitalized for say a 14 to 18 day period, attended by a team of 1 doctor and 3 nurses with 8 hour shift on a 24 hour basis, would require approximately 4 sets of PPE units. For 18 days, a single patient would require approximately 18 into 4, that is 72 PPE suits for the personnels, that is doctors and nurses attending to him. A set of 3 nurses with 1 doctor can handle 8 patients at a time. India, if we presume, has 1 lakh corona patients, corona positive cases, over a period of time would require approximately 10,000 into 72, that is 7,20,000 PPE suits. Now, this is a very relative number because apart from the doctor nurses ratio, it is also required by field personnel, police professionals, as well as the field warriors and supporting staff like drivers, etc., who go along to attend for the COVID patients. An approximation of approximately 18 lakh units or 8 million units is what is the total demand as we estimate on a monthly basis. This number is bound to go up. It will not come down. The government has silently released a purchase order of 6 million units of PPE along with equivalent of testing units from China. This is quite surprising in spite of having production facility in India. Why the Indian government is doing so and running after Chinese imports, maybe because of cost or someone else is benefiting from such environment. Only time will tell whether why this has been ordered on to the Chinese companies. The ideal situation should be manufacturing from India. So the first important question is why import from China when we can manufacture in India? These PPE suits can be manufactured within India. In fact, manufacturing has already started in Ludhiana, Punjab and Gujarat. A link has been shared for your references. As and when the lockdown is reduced and manufacturers are allowed, this is the ideal situation where this war should be incorporated along with the Indian manufacturers on a very large scale to manufacture PPE suits. We, three individuals have come together as a group, an informal group called Citizens Against Corona, which is helping to facilitate Indian PPE suits and masks for hospitals and other citizen groups for providing PPE kits in large numbers so that we can defeat the coronavirus in India. The Citizens Against Corona group, essentially right now we have three members, which is Rishi Mehta, Ravindra Sethi and Sujoy Chaurasia, with the respective company names mentioned, who have come together to bring or facilitate the Indian manufactured PPE units to be supplied to various hospitals, government agencies, contractors and all those who are involved in fighting against the corona war which is going on in India. All individuals who would like to join our effort in facilitating this supply chain are most welcome to join us, whether you are manufacturers, suppliers, traders or individuals and contractors seeking such a kind of equipment to be utilized in various agencies of government, are free to contact us. You can either leave a comment on the section below this YouTube link or email to the mail link given below in this presentation. We are also sharing a WhatsApp number. Kindly help us support in the war against corona. We have mentioned how you can support in the link of description given below this video. Thank you very much, friends.